What is love? I know what love is because I was taught it when I was young. I was taught that love is patient, love is kind. Love does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always preserves. Love never fails. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8. Welcome to Just Trying, the channel where we find joy in new everyday things. This month, I have been learning how to write scripts, and today I would like to talk about the trouble I have been having writing romance. Knowing the definition that I just read from the Bible of love is true in any form of love, friendships, family members, romance, doesn't matter. Writing a romance script is still going to be difficult. Not because I know that I have never once written a romantic thing, not because there are very little real romantic shows out there, simply because how can one write romance if I've never seen a healthy romantic relationship? My parents are divorced, as are many other people. It's not shocking or even a surprising thing to hear. So how can we show true love? How am I supposed to write if I haven't even seen a representation of it? I hear that people are dating or almost like best friends, so I can just look at my own friends, but I don't think that will really work. I've only really got 3 friends. None of them are really dating, which is fine, but one of those friends has parents that have a really great relationship, but these are people I hardly see, so I hardly get to see a functional romantic relationship. And to be honest, the whole idea of seeing very little healthy romantic relationships scares me. Let's back this up a little bit. The last few generations on my dad's side, including my dad, haven't really been the best marriages, and they were eventually set free from those bad marriages. And when I go to church, mostly when I hear people talk about relationships, I just hear how Jackson and Charlotte are doing bad, or if anyone needs to go to couple therapy, just sign up. And even the fact that we have divorce groups in the church. All of that is fine to hear because people need to heal and grow better, but it terrifies me. I mean, all the relationships I've seen, which to be fair are not many, don't exactly end up too happy or good. It makes me wonder, will I end up with a guy who falls out of love with me? Who isn't a person of God, who mistreats me. In middle school, very little people talk to me, and fewer people romantically write to me. I was told I was annoying and to just shut up. I know I've changed a lot, but what happens if my marriage ends up like that? I mean, it's still something I'm rather insecure about. In high school, no guy that I knew had a crush on me. There's maybe one guy that I thought could've, but it was never confirmed. No one slid into my DMs, no one complimented me beyond my friends and family. And as I'm writing this, it made me wonder, was I ugly? Am I ugly? And this isn't an ugly cry for validation, I don't need your validation. I know I'm beautiful, but I cannot deny that these are questions that fill my mind as I think about this. And I see a lot of people like me out there feel the same way. In high school, everyone knew my name. Popular people were kind to me, and no one had any guff or issues with me. And I had friends in high school, more or less. So, why did no one like me? Did I do something wrong? Am I wrong? Do I have the wrong thinking about relationships? When I talked to my friends in high school about relationships, I remember one comment that stuck out from a very good friend of mine. She said as we're walking to class from lunch, "You don't seem like a person to date someone that you aren't already friends with, that you don't already know for a few years." I replied to her, "Well, what's the point of dating if I don't want to be with this person for the rest of my life?" She just smiled and turned away, shaking her head just a little bit. I don't know if she agreed or disagreed with me, and I don't really think that's the point. I think the point of her statement, and the point I'm trying to make here, is that people date for fun, which is fine, as long as your partner knows and is okay with that. Don't control someone's emotions. It's not right, and that's not healthy. Control your own emotions first, and then maybe you can see if you can handle other people's emotions, and even then, it's not your place. The reason I bring this story up, I just want you to understand my mindset when it comes to dating or courting. I know it's realistic to want to know someone before you date them, so that way you can understand who and what kind of relationship you could be getting into. I know that these feelings are just insecurities, and now I'm gonna work through them. But if it really starts to bother me, I can always talk to someone about it. The important thing is I know who I am, so these insecurities don't have a place over me. I am a child of God, I am a woman of character and integrity, because God wants me that way, and I want to be that way, because He wants me to be. I don't need a relationship to define who I am. I'm perfectly fine without that. I have a relationship with God, and obviously, when or even if God wants me to get married, He'll bring the right guy along. I'm just deciding to state in a way that's speaking life. Thank you very much for watching. And I want you to know that if you face the same fears as me, we will get over this together. You don't have a choice. I'm dragging you with me. We will improve together and everything will be a-okay. So please like, comment, and join the ride and subscribe. And don't forget to hit that bell button.
This is not copyright. Do, 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 not copyright. We're all at peace. Not copyright. Do, do, do.
And that's going to be the end music for a while because I don't have music.